Hi and welcome back to our channel. Today we're addressing a common problem faced by Mac users, which is the trackpad not working issue. Whether you're dealing with a Mac mouse not working or a trackpad not responding, we've got you covered with some practical solutions. But before we get started, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, leave your comments down below, and interact with our community. Okay, let's dive into making your Mac experience seamless once again. Before we jump into the fixes, it's crucial to understand why you might be facing trackpad issues. Common culprits include software glitches, misconfigured settings, or even hardware wear and tear. Whether it's a MacBook trackpad not clicking or a MacBook Air trackpad not responding, identifying the cause is the first step to a solution. Sometimes the environment plays a role. Extreme temperatures or humidity can affect your trackpad's responsiveness. If you're working in an unusually hot climate or have had liquid spill incidents, these could be factors worth considering. Accidental drops or pressure on your Mac can also lead to internal damage, which can in turn affect the trackpad. It's not always visible on the surface, but internal misalignments or damage can cause the trackpad to stop working. Regular wear and tear over time can also contribute to trackpad issues, especially in older Mac models. Occasionally, third-party applications can interfere with the trackpad's functionality, so if you've recently installed new software and noticed the trackpad not responding, there could be a conflict. Identifying and resolving these conflicts is crucial for restoring trackpad functionality. Using external mice or trackpads can sometimes cause setting changes or conflicts. If you frequently switch between built-in and external pointing devices, ensure that the settings are correctly configured for each use case. Understanding these factors helps in accurately diagnosing the issue, leading to more effective solutions. Stay tuned as we delve into specific methods to address these causes and get your trackpad back to optimal functioning. Click the Apple icon on the top left and choose About This Mac. Click on More Info and see if there is a software update available for your computer. If updates are available, be sure to install them as this can improve trackpad compatibility and functionality. For MacBooks with a removable battery, shut down the computer, remove the battery, press and hold the power button for 5 seconds, reinsert the battery and power on the Mac. For MacBooks without a removable battery, shut down the computer, press Shift, Control and Option on the left-hand side and the power button simultaneously for 10 seconds. Release the buttons and turn on your Mac. For Mac desktops, shut the computer down, unplug the main power cord, wait for 15 seconds before plugging the power cord back in again, wait 5 more seconds and then turn the Mac on. Firstly, shut down your Mac. Turn it on and immediately press and hold the Option, Command, P and R keys. Hold these keys for about 20 seconds. During this time, your Mac might appear to restart. Release the keys after the second startup sound or after the Apple logo appears and disappears for the second time. From the Finder, press Command Shift G and enter /library/preferences. Find and delete files containing com.apple.driver.applehidmouse.plist and files containing com.apple.applemultitouchtrackpad.plist. Empty the trash and restart your Mac. Click the Apple icon and choose System Settings. Click General and select Software Update. If any updates are available, click Upgrade Now. Then follow the prompts to download and install the latest Mac OS version. The solution for this is adjusting the double click speed. To do this, open System Settings from the Apple menu, click on Accessibility, select Pointer Control from the sidebar, find the Double Click Speed slider and adjust it. Move the slider towards Slow to increase the time interval allowed between clicks for a double click. Test the new setting by double-clicking on a folder or a file to see if it improves the response. The solution for this is modifying the trackpad sensitivity. To do this, go to System Settings and select Trackpad. Under the Point and Click tab, locate the Tracking Speed slider. Adjust the slider to increase or decrease the tracking speed. Moving it to the right speeds up the pointer, and moving it to the left slows it down. Experiment with different speeds to find the most comfortable setting for your use. The solution for this is resetting the trackpad. Firstly, try restarting your Mac, as sometimes a simple restart can resolve temporary glitches. If the issue persists, try resetting the System Management Controller, or SMC. The steps for this will vary based on your particular Mac model, so refer to Apple's official guidelines for your specific model. Next, check for any updates by going to the System Settings area, choosing Software Update, and installing the latest macOS version. This can resolve compatibility and bug-related issues. If the problem continues, consider creating a new user account to test if the issue is user-specific. To do this, go to System Settings, choose Users and Groups, and add a new account for testing purposes. And that brings us to the end of today's video. Thank you so much for watching. We hope these methods help you to resolve your Mac trackpad issues. Don't hesitate to comment down below with your experiences or any questions. Subscribe for more helpful content just like this, and turn on notifications to stay updated.